Hi, welcome to Taipei. In this video, we will talk about Taipei GUI, a local tool that allows you to create intuitive user interface that is low-code, such that you can easily create a complete data-driven web application in just a fraction of the time that it usually takes. So now, let's create your first Taipei application with just two lines of code. Let's first import Taipei GUI and create a simple web page with a message. If you haven't watched our Taipei introduction video, a Taipei page is set up as a Python string that follows the augmented markdown format. This allows developers to edit the styling of the web page with ease and makes inserting Taipei's visual elements a seamless task. Let's run it. As you can see, the word Taipei is in italics because it was put between two star characters. If you're not very familiar with the markdown syntax, I have included in the description a cheat sheet that you can reference to. So you see how simple it is to use Taipei GUI. Now, suppose you have a Python variable, whether it is a string or an integer, you can always insert it in your web page using variable visual element with the following syntax. So let's do it now. One of the things that sets Taipei GUI apart is the library of visual elements that we continuously developed and add to Taipei, such that you can always find what you need. From button, input box, sliders, chart, and many things else, you are set up for everything. So let's create an application with a slider that changes a Python integer that you and your user can interact with. Here we have a Python integer with value 10, and I am adding a slider visual element to the page and run the app. As you can see, the slider is there. I can move the button, but it's not doing anything. What I want is for it to be able to change the variable value above. In other words, to bind the value to the slider. This can be done by just specifying the first parameter of the slider. Run the application, and now changing the slider will modify the value integer. I can't think of a simpler way to do so. Let's now use charts. A visual element that is probably going to be used the most by Taipei users. In this part, I want to create an interactive cosinus graph from a decay variable and have that variable linked to a slider so that we can see the slider directly changes the graph as the decay variable changes. So I am defining a compute data function to produce a set of results to be plotted. I also want to introduce you to the onChange function concept. So basically, every instance of the web application is called a state. And whenever something is changed, the state is modified. Taipei GUI will automatically scan, and if a variable is updated, the on-chain functions will be executed. And in this case, whenever the decay is changed, the function compute data will update the data variable and show it on the graph accordingly. And the last thing to do is to add a chart visual element that is linked to the data variable.